The Philippines information technology and business process management sector may continue existing work-from-home arrangements until further notice. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno issued the memorandum retaining the 70% on-site and 30% work-from-home arrangement until the Fiscal Incentives Review Board formally decides on it. The board ordered BPO employees to return to offices in April, but some firms have secured a letter of authority to extend the hybrid setup until this month. Well, how are BPOs receiving this news? Let's talk with the president and CEO of the IT Business Process Association of the Philippines, or IBPAP, Jack Madrid. Good afternoon, Jack, and thank you so much for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Rain. Always a pleasure to speak with you.
May we get your reaction to the FIRB allowing the provisional extension of 30% work from home setup?
You know, Rain, my initial reaction and that of the investors of our country was of relief. This was a long time coming, but ultimately we are glad that, you know, the Department of Finance finally listen to the voice of the industry, the voice of the investors, and most importantly, the voice of the employees who have been working very effectively from a location-independent setup since the onset of the pandemic. So we're relieved, and we are also looking forward to a more permanent and much-needed long-term solution.
You're saying that there's a clamor for and an overwhelming preference for work from home or hybrid work expressed by employees, as well as global trends showing this, and it should make government's decision to consider allowing the work setup even more compelling. What are the experiences and trends that you're seeing here and abroad?
You know, the overwhelming majority of the Filipino workforce and the employers as well, who are very sensitive about the employees' well-being and health, have expressed a very strong preference for a location-independent or hybrid work setup. We experience extremely high productivity levels without any dip in customer satisfaction ratings from our global customers through the pandemic, and that was no small feat, you know, having to migrate and mobilize 1 million employees from on-site operations as well as their IT equipment to a work from home setup. So that challenge was impressively performed and hurdled by our Filipino workforce, proving that we are the world capital of the IT BPM industry, of course, alongside India. This need and importance of a hybrid work setup is a worldwide phenomenon. And we have just been communicating to our partners in government how important this is to attract and retain global investors and grow our industry even more. We have seen, you know, countries like India already enact work from home hybrid setups, decoupling it from any tax incentives, even at a more aggressive 50-50 work from home work on site ratio. So, you know, I think the local industry here in the Philippines, we have proven what we can do, the quality of service that we can deliver. And I think, you know, in order for our industry to grow in the next 6 years, and we have a goal of adding over 1 million jobs for Filipinos through 2028. And this can only be achieved by more enlightened legislation and, you know, reduce this whole uncertainty that you know, is damaging the image of the Philippines as a credible investment destination. So I think we're on the right track, and we are hopeful that a more permanent long-term solution will be found.
So you're not looking forward to any elevation or escalation of the current setup to 100% on site. Currently, would you be able to share with us how much of the workforce in the IT and BPO industry is work from home? Which functions are those? And if the sector had its way, how much of the workforce would be work from home? You mentioned that it affected productivity. It didn't affect productivity. It's actually remained high. But what about the bottom line and maybe the overall morale among the staff?
That's a great insightful question, Rain. And it's also a difficult one to answer because every company, every investor or employer, and every customer has its own preferences for what that optimal hybrid ratio will be. At present, I would say for the overall industry, and I'm talking about 1.5 million Filipinos in our industry, we are probably close to a 55 to 60% ratio, and that would be work from home, whereas 40, 45% would be would be working on site. So there is no one size fits all or magic number. It really depends on the trifecta of employer, employee, and of course customer. Our industry has diversified and matured over the past decades that we cannot just generalize that a BPO operation will have similar setups. We have diversified across the entire range of global services, not just basic customer service anymore, which is where the industry began, but including we now include financial services, insurance, healthcare, information management, and even creative industries like animation and game development. So that optimal number will vary, but I think based on what we've seen and the surveys we've conducted, I think 70-30 in general will be acceptable. But if we had our way, to your question, we would like full flexibility to allow our customers, our employees, and our investors to run the business the way they want so that they can serve their customers and cement our market share and reputation as a country where outsourcing and offshoring is extremely well done.
And still be able to keep the incentives with PEZA?
I think, incentives that have been given by the investment promotion agency should be separate from our work setup. I mean, our industry being online is unlike manufacturing, where physical presence in the economic zone is really needed. We have proven in the past 2 years that our work can be done from any location. We have not vacated our offices. The data centers are still housed in the data center. So there is activity there, maybe not 100% of the employees, but there will always be a ratio of physical presence for our employees, regardless of the industry.
Mm-hmm. Now, Jack, if the FIRB had its way and the industry is forced to bring all staff back to on-site operations, how does that change productivity, morale, and the bottom line?
That would dramatically change the landscape of our industry. It would certainly have an effect on employees who have enjoyed, the benefits of being able to stay home with their families while work very productively. So the initial reaction would probably be an increase in industry attrition. Because employees that my team and I have spoken to, majority of them have expressed, intent to leave their place of employment if they do not have this flexibility in work setup. So I worry about attrition. And if attrition becomes more serious, then we will see, a dip and reduction in the Philippines' market share. Because it is not just the Philippines and India anymore, Rain. It is countries from non-traditional regions such as Poland, Malaysia, and South Africa that have emerged as IT BPM locators. So, there is a global war for talent. There is far more demand for Filipino talent than we can supply. So any reduction in market share will be detrimental to the industry as a whole and our ability to grow that 1 million jobs by 2028.
That's right. And with that prospect of growth, with the International Innovation Summit that you're hosting, you're expecting that the Philippine IT BPM sector could come together for discussions on how to make more impact through countryside development, digital enabled services, dollar revenue, high complexity work, and indirect employment with the help of ESG. Can you tell us more about this?
Yes, the International Innovation Summit, or IIS, is the biggest IT BPM industry in the Philippines. And we have a very impressive list of global and local speakers that will participate in our event. And I'm excited to share with you that for the first time in 2 years, we are actually going to have a hybrid, very appropriate to the times, event wherein it will be both conducted virtually and face-to-face. Now, the topics that you mentioned, Rain, are indeed very relevant. These are the building blocks of our industry blueprint, because in the IIS, we will be launching the Roadmap 2028, something that my team and I have worked very hard on in the past few months with our research partner, the Everest Group. And this will outline and articulate our industry's plans, objectives, and metrics to grow this industry to 2.5 million Filipinos by 2028, delivering a potential revenue of $59 billion, which will clearly make us the biggest job generator of the country and the single largest source of foreign exchange, which our country badly needs. So, you know, there's a lot going on. We are at a seminal moment in the global industry. And I think I would like nothing more than to discuss all of that with our partners in government. We have invited the president to do our closing keynote, and I will be handing him Roadmap 2028, because it is not just IBPAP's roadmap, it is the country's and our economy's roadmap. So we want that co-ownership between the public sector, the private sector, and of course, IBPAP, who will be the voice of the industry in the years ahead.
Well, we're looking forward to details of that roadmap and the results of the Innovation Summit. IBPAP's Jack Madrid, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us today. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Rain.